In the previous movie, we imported a human into our scene and scripted him to stay within the bounds of our simulation space. In this movie, we'll create some custom attributes to better control our simulation and also introduce our zombie to the scene. Open the scene titled Zombie Apocalypse Part 2 Start. You'll notice that this scene is more dressed up than our previously walled plane. However, the internal dimensions are the same as before. Let's start by creating some attributes to better control the speed and agility of our human. Select the human group object in the outliner, open the channel box, and go to the Edit Add Attributes command. First, create a speed attribute. We're going to make this value a float. Float signifies that we can assign a number with a decimal value, whereas with an int or integer, we can only assign whole numbers. Decimals will allow us to better fine-tune our speed. Now set the default value to 10. Click the Add button to add the attribute. You'll see it appear at the bottom of the channel box. Add a second float attribute named Agility and give it a default value of 5. Now that we have our custom attributes, let's make use of them. Open the expression editor and filter the objects by expression name. Select the rotate expression. Until now, we had hard-coded the arguments of our random number generator. Instead, let's use our new humangroup.agility attribute to make this expression customizable. Remember to keep the negative operator on the first argument, otherwise our random number generator will generate a number between 5 and 5, which is not very random at all. Notice that with a lower value of 5 versus 15, the human rotates a lot less. The beauty of our custom attribute is that we can now fine-tune this rotation by simply modifying his agility value. Now let's modify the move expression the same way. Remember that our move expression is connected to the timing of the scene, but not a specific attribute. Unfortunately, this means we can't simply call values by inputting humangroup.something. Instead, we're going to use another mel command to fetch the attribute data we need. Replace the z value with the following command. The mel command structure itself is fairly straightforward, but don't forget to include the tilde symbols, which identify to Maya that the phrase within is all one command. Now if you play the scene, you can alter the speed attribute just like the agility attribute to modify the human's walking speed. Notice that the human's walk cycle is not affected by the speed attribute. If you make him too fast or too slow, he'll start to glide. Let's reset these values to their defaults. Now let's introduce our human to a zombie. Since a zombie is really nothing more than a slower human, minus the rotting flesh, we're going to use our human as a base. Select the human group object and duplicate it by pressing Ctrl-D. Move the new human aside and rename it Zombie Group. If you play the scene, you'll notice that while our zombie has retained the custom attributes of our human, he's not moving. There are two reasons for this. The first is that our original move expression referenced only the human. And the second is that the rotate expression attached to our original human is not carried over when we create a regular duplicate. You can see this more clearly if you select both objects and open the Hypergraph Connections editor. Notice that our zombie node isn't attached to a rotate node like the human is. To carry over this connection, we'll need to use the duplicate special command. Delete the zombie group and select the human again. This time, go to the duplicate special options. In the duplicate special options, we'll turn on duplicate input graph. Select the duplicated human and rename him zombie group, then move him off the original human. If you play the scene, you'll now see that the duplicated human animates and rotates correctly. This is further confirmed if we look at the hypergraph, where we can see both the human and zombie are now connected to rotate expression nodes. Now we just need to update the move expression with the zombie. In the expression editor, select the move expression and duplicate the script. Change all the references of human to zombie. Now we can use our zombie's handy speed and agility attribute values to slow him down to a speed of 1 and agility of 2. The duplicated human moves much slower than the original one, which makes sense considering he's supposed to be a zombie. To make it really clear though, let's change his mesh to look a little more zombie-like. Select the zombie group in the outliner and return all the translation values to 0. Delete the human mesh inside. Import the zombie shuffle file. This model looks much more appropriate for a brain-hungry zombie. Select the zombie shuffle colon zombie geo node and middle mouse drag it into the zombie group node. Rename it to zombie geo. Make sure you set all the translation and rotation values of the zombie geo node to 0. Now play the scene. As you can see, replacing the model has not affected our simulation at all. This is because all our scripts only manipulate the zombie group node above it. Now we have both a human and a zombie roaming around our graveyard. You can fine-tune their individual speed and agility as you like. In the next movie, you'll learn how to use loops and variables to populate the entire scene.